In a Brayton cycle, air enters the compressor at 100 kilopascals and 298 Kelvin. The pressure leaving the compressor is 1 megapascals and the maximum temperature of the cycle is 1240 Kelvin. Let's say we know that the isentropic efficiency is 80% for the compressor and 85% for the turbine. What is the specific work of the compressor and what is the temperature at the exit of the compressor? As usual, pause here and try solving this problem yourself before watching the solution. This is the first example for the Brayton cycle main lecture, and it uses concepts from the isentropic efficiency main lecture too, so make sure you've studied those two lectures before attempting to solve this problem. The links to those 11 and 8 minute lectures respectively, and all of the other lectures of the Thermo course are found in the description below. Let's start by plotting a TS diagram for this cycle. If we call the air before the compressor state 1, we would see the temperature of 298 Kelvin as T1, and T3 would be the maximum temperature. In the real cycle, real 2 is just to the right of 2S, just as 4 is to the right of 4S. The specific work of the compressor will be the specific enthalpy at the exit minus the specific enthalpy at the inlet, meaning H2 minus H1. Since the efficiency of the compressor is defined as the theoretical ideal work H2S minus H1 over the real work that we're trying to find, the work we're looking for is H2S minus H1 over the efficiency value. H1 we can find from the property tables for air at the given temperature 1, and H2S will be the corresponding specific enthalpy value for an isentropic process from 1 to 2. We have two options here to find state 2S. Since we have the pressure values at 1 and 2, we can use the relationship between Ps and Prs, or we could use the entropy change expression and say it should be 0, since from 1 to 2S we assume isentropy. Let's go with the first option since it's quicker. We solve for PR2, we notice we need PR1, we look for PR1 from the table value that corresponds to T1, and we substitute the values to find PR2. With this value, we see that there needs to exist a specific enthalpy value that corresponds to that PR value. Since this PR value is not exactly one of the ones in the table, we notice that we need to interpolate between 13.5 and 14.38. We interpolate, like we've done multiple times before, and find the value for H2S. And finally, we now substitute it to calculate the specific work of the compressor. Now for the temperature, notice that interpolating to find the corresponding T value to the PR2 number would give us the temperature for the isentropic ideal case, not the real temperature at the exit of the compressor. To find this temperature, what we want is to find the corresponding T value to the real H2 specific enthalpy. Since we have the work of the compressor, and that is equal to H2 minus H1, we can solve for H2 and substitute both the work and H1 to find its value. With this value for H2, we can look it up in the table and use the closest H values there to interpolate and find the corresponding temperature T2. If you want to check out other examples in the ideal and non-ideal Brayton cycles topic, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below. You'll also find the links to the other lectures of the Thermo course as well as other engineering courses. Thanks for watching!